Nice. Let's go. That's OT. I mean, one, I kind of got tangled up with McDavid, then puck was loose, and two guys go for it for them, and Kale makes an unreal play. Stuff what Kale always does, great sauce to me, and I managed to score.
Was that an exciting and fun game?
Yeah, a little bit too exciting. You know, obviously fun for people to watch, but, you know, we got to be a little tighter in the second. We played a great first and third. You know, everything was self-induced in the second, which is good, you know. Yeah, we don't want to do that too much. So. Yeah, he's been awesome. A couple shout-outs. Carolina, he was amazing. He's been great. He's getting better and better as the season goes along, I think. You know, we're missing a lot of guys right now, too. The guys we traded for, and then Landy, Bo, and G. So pretty big players for us, and excited to get back full on up it. Thought it was great. The players we traded, the prospects, are going to be good players, but we're so deep right now, it's going to be tough for those guys to play for 3-4 years, and we'll probably all be gone in 3-4 years. So we need to win now, and that's the message Joe's sending to all of us, coaching staff. Not that our plan was any different, but everyone's all in. And we're excited to get Lehkonen, Mance, obviously, Sturmey, and Cogliano. You know, amazing additions, everything I think we need. So really excited.
Is there still an extra charge?
I don't know. Just anytime you play the best players in the world, or he is the best player in the league, in my opinion. You know, guy wins a scoring title every year. He's amazing. So it's always fun to play against Connor, Sid, Matthews, even, you know, Dreisaitl. So anytime you get to play against those guys, it's a lot of fun. Yeah, it's great. I mean, Mikko's been amazing all season. He's one of the best players in the league as well. So he always finds a way to score power play goals. I don't know what the numbers are, but I feel like every year he's up there in power play goals. Just quick puck movement. You know, we've been great lately. You know, we're going 2-for-2, 1-for-1, and we got a few tonight that we could have scored on even more. So pretty gassed in the third there, but a lot of good puck movement. Kale, Mikko, the whole group was really sharp tonight. Yeah, I think it's just this go time now. You know, whether we win or lose, we just need to play in preparation for the playoffs. And obviously our second period wasn't a playoff type of period. You know, I think in years past in the playoffs, it's been self-induced mistakes that would cost us games. You know, we have all the talent in the world. We can chip it in and create a goal just from ozone play. We don't have to try to make a play off the rush. So I think it's just learning. You know, it'll be good to have some good team meetings and get to know the new guys even more and integrate them quickly. And, you know, it's a late trade deadline. You know, basketball was like a month ago or something. You know, us, we have like 18 games left. So we got to get together quickly and, you know, get ready for the playoffs.
What's your interaction with Gabe after the game? Call each other? Were you just talking
to talk? Yeah, he texted me. You know, Gabe's still around all the time. You know, he's our captain. He's our leader. And it's always great to see him. You know, he's such a great guy and so supportive even when he's out right now, but he's working hard to get healthy, and we definitely miss him. Yeah, ever since I came back from that hit from against Boston, it's been pretty good. I think just the, you know, I'm not going to shoot 2% forever. You know, I'm going to get hot eventually, so. You know, a few posts in there as well. I just had to trust it. You know, definitely some overthinking goes into it when you got 3 and 20, for sure. But you know, instead of stick with it, and they're going in a little bit now for sure. He came, yeah, he came here once with Toronto, I think, and then that's it. So, yeah, it's always great to see Tyson, one of my best friends, still came over last night and hung out, and such a great person, and great player as well. And yeah, it's always, it's hard to take him serious out there, honestly. He's so funny, but such a great guy, and it's always fun to play against him. Yeah, he said he'd send McDermott out for him. That's what he was saying. He's a dummy, yeah. So, yeah.
Didn't love it. Yeah. I mean, there's aspects of our game that I really liked. I liked our first period. I thought we had good jump. Did some good things. Power play was outstanding. Penalty kill was good. That's the difference in the hockey game for me. And I liked our third. I'll be honest. I liked our third. We got more physical, more involved. I thought we were playing on the end of our stick in the second period, and we were kicking the puck around. Like, I didn't think our execution was poor. You know, we turned a lot of pucks over in the neutral zone, so it was a little bit of a track meet back and forth. The exact game you don't want to play against Edmonton. Their rush numbers are tops of the league. And rush goals are tops of the league, and you turn the puck over, they're a great transition team. So to me, we didn't make them work hard enough in the defensive zone for stretches in the middle part of the game.
No, it's not the why.
Yeah, too fun. That's the thing.
How is Ryan Murray?
He's I don't know. We'll know more tomorrow. But I mean, he took that shot, as everyone saw, and hit him in the upper body. Hand, arm, whatever, and he's getting looked at. But the fact that he couldn't come back means he's going to miss a little bit of time. I don't know how long yet. We'll figure it out tomorrow. How is he? Oh, I thought he had a tough night. Yeah, I thought a bunch of our guys did. You know, like, that. Just the execution, the puck play. Yeah, it didn't look like we were skating like we could early on, and part of that was execution. We were always waiting on a puck. It was always a balancing puck in our feet. Like, playing fast is not just skating, but it just felt like we couldn't get, like, going a little bit during the middle part of the game because we were, you know, we just weren't good with the puck.
Your perspective on the
Yeah, so I don't know a lot about Lekkonen. I've watched him a little bit on video. But our pro guys, scouts, Joe, Chris, really like him a lot. I know I didn't get to see last year's playoffs, their first two rounds, because we were playing, and then I didn't watch the Vegas round at all because I just didn't want to. So, but I heard he was really good in the playoffs. I understand that he's a real, like, he, and from what I've seen of video, he's a real hard-working guy. Like, he's got a real good motor, decent skater, he's tenacious on pucks. Like, he does a lot of really good things on the defensive side of things, but he chips in offensively. Good shape, like a real good, like, teammate type guy. Middle six forward, but good penalty killer, led their team, or was second on their team for a couple of years and led their team this year on penalty kill ice time. So I think, you know, we get a guy that's going to be able to help us and fill a checking role with offensive guys. Like, you know, it's another guy to play with in that top six even that can help us shut down teams like this, you know, and still produce offense. Yeah, I think he's a good add too, because another real good penalty kill guy. He's quick. He's not the biggest guy, but he plays really physical. Like, he's hard on pucks and in the battles, and he's got great experience. So this is a guy that's hungry to win, and you know, he does a lot of those things. You know, like Helm type player. Yeah. I thought he was really good. Yeah, I thought Smith was good too. Like, we had some, and they probably it probably showed up most on the power plays and penalty kills. Now we got more opportunities on the power play, but we had a bunch of really good looks. And Smith looked good on. We missed a couple, hit a couple posts. But Darcy made some big saves. There's one down low through the crease that he got over on, put his pad on. The guy couldn't elevate it. It was in tight. 2-on-1. I mean, he made some real nice saves. He looked better as the game went on too. So yeah, I thought he was really good in the third. Yeah, you got to do your job defensively. You know, like even before the overtime, I talked to Mac, like you got to check. Like it's, you know, I try to reiterate that all the time. Sometimes they listen, sometimes they don't. Because Mac knows like that Goudreau got in behind him, you know, a couple games ago and he let him go. And the next thing you know, the pass is made. You have to do your job on the checking side of it. And the more physical you can get and knock a guy off the puck, then you're right in attack mode right away. And the guy like Val, like we started him out there, or got him out there with, he's just so lethal on 3-on-3. He's like turned into maybe our best player 3-on-3. He picks the puck up in the neutral zone. It's almost impossible to keep him from driving the net, you know? So we're experimenting with a couple different things just to, you know, play guys like that with our top guys. So they're top guys like think offense, 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 and like forget about their other responsibility, but we're getting better at it. We've talked a lot about it, and like I said, some nights were really good, and some nights not so much.
Yeah, I was about to say, you got another.
Yeah. Well, that was just what we called the line, and I don't think Sturm heard it. Like, it was McKinnon, Kadri, and I came back to McKinnon and told everyone, and our McKinnon's line was jumping, and all of a sudden Sturm jumped on the ice. So I don't know. He was sleeping when I called the line, I guess. So sometimes it happens. The ones that bother me are like lazy changes, like when guys are coming off and kind of coming but not coming hard. Other guys are waiting for them, plays getting ready to go, or the guys going on the ice aren't watching the play. Like they're just looking at you coming off, and then they look away, and then you turn back out, and they're still jumping on. That's like, it's all a mental error is what it is. Every time it's almost as a mental error, but like, I don't like the lazy changes. That one, I just don't know if he just didn't hear me or what happened there.
I know you said this morning that you don't pay too much attention to the trade deadline stuff, but how nice is it knowing that's done, you know who the team is,
yeah.
You know who's going to be here, now you guys can
start. Yeah, it's great. It's great. Yeah, that's the one thing I'm concerned about, is just getting through that. And so we have our team and we can get to work. We have to get better in the last 20 games, and we have to fine tune some things, and we got to find chemistry on our lines. So we got lots of time from the play together. Unfortunately, we're missing Landy, which would be nice to have him, but we'll get to experiment with other guys on other lines and match them up against some guys and see what works and what doesn't. Yep, Cogliano will be here tomorrow, and Lehkonen's waiting on immigration, so he's a, you know, who knows. Yeah, it could be a couple days or longer. Yeah, thanks.